Good morning, Prairie Chase Hawks. I'm Palmer from Ms. Leatherman's class.
And I'm Anania from Ms. Nell's class, and welcome to this edition of WPTE.
What an amazing week we've had.
We just had Thanksgiving break, and it's nice to have a full week with everyone back again.
Hey, you want to hear a joke?
Sure, I love jokes.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Snow.
Snow who?
Snow time to waste. It's almost winter break. Ha ha ha. Speaking of no time to waste, did you know it's time to start working on your yearbook cover submissions?
If you want your artwork to be on the front of the yearbook this year, draw a design to submit to Ms. Dragish or Ms. Nettle.
Be sure that it says Prairie Chase Elementary, the years 2023 to 2024, and the portrait style, and its portrait style, which means longer up and longer down.
Also, make sure that everything is neat and spelled correctly.
Submissions are due December 15th, so make sure to get to them on time.
If you have any questions, just talk to Ms. Dragish or Ms. Nuttall. Now let's send it over to Book Blurb.
Sophie and Chelsea, take it away.
Hi, I'm Sophie from Ms. Van Dam's class.
Hi, I'm Chelsea, also from Mrs. Van Dam's class. And welcome to this edition of Book Blurb.
Chelsea, have you ever read the book Mindy Kim and the Birthday Puppy by Lila Lee?
Yes, it's about a girl who is turning 8 years old and gets a puppy for her birthday.
She was anxious to get a puppy and her dad surprised her with it on her birthday.
Mindy then had to teach Theodore tricks so he would behave.
She tries really hard to teach the puppy and he finally sits and gets potty trained.
Also do other things like dance and lay.
This is a great book for all ages K through 5th.
You can find it in the Media Center.
Now back to the studio with Anania and Palmer.
Thanks, Chelsea and Sophie. That sounds like a great book.
All that talk of birthdays makes me think of cake, which is making me hungry. What's for lunch today?
Today's hot lunch is chicken smackers, chicken Caesar salad, and a side of mashed potatoes. There's also an option of hummus and PB&J.
Mmm, sounds so good. Anania, is anybody selling a birthday at Prairie Trace today?
Yes, today's birthdays are Leah Archer, Christian Abel, Wendy Yang, and Grace Cassis, and Miss Trebbing.
Happy birthday! Go down to the office to claim your birthday treats.
Next up is Amber with the weather. What can we expect this weekend?
Hello, Precious Hawks. I am Amber from the Snow Scouts, and welcome to this week's edition of weather. Today, there is a 98% chance of rain with a high of 45 and a low of 40. I'm sure to wear a rain jacket before I go outside. Tomorrow, it will be cloudy with a 24% chance of rain with a high of 50 and a low of 30. Sunday, we'll have a 50% chance of rain with a high of 52 and a low of 37. That's all for weather. Now back to the studio with Palma and Anania.
Thanks, Amber. It looks like it's going to be pretty rainy this weekend.
Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. My name is Maddie, and welcome to this week's edition of sports. Today, Carmel High School boys basketball team will be playing Lawrence Central at 7:30 p.m. Tomorrow, girls varsity basketball will play Richmond at 3:30 p.m. Also tomorrow, boys varsity basketball will be playing Plainfield at 7:30 p.m. Go Greyhounds! IU men's basketball is playing Maryland and Bloomington at 7 p.m. Purdue men's basketball is playing Northwestern in Evanston, Illinois at 9 p.m. On Sunday, the Colts are playing the Tennessee Titans at the Nissan Stadium. Kickoff is at 1 p.m. Saturday, the Pacers are playing away against Miami Heat, and it is at 8 p.m. That's all for this weekend sports. Now back to Palmer and Anania in the studio.
To all our Indiana teams.
Shannon, next with National Days. Let's see what National Days we can celebrate today.
Hello, I am Shane from Ms. Nuttall's class, and welcome to this edition of National Days. Today is Eat a Red Apple Day, so when I go home, I'll make sure to eat a bright red apple. On Saturday, it is Fritters Day, so I will make sure to have an apple fritter for dinner. On Sunday, it is Make a Gift Day, so I will make sure I will make a gift for someone special to me. On Monday is Wear Brown Shoes Day. I'll make sure to wear my brown shoes. That is all for National Days. Now back to the studio with Palmer and Ananya.
Hi, I'm Arjun from Ms. Davis's class.
And I'm Amaya from Ms. Leatherman's class with this week's edition of
Did You Know? Did you know it would only take 1 hour to drive to space if you could drive straight up in the air?
No, I didn't, but did you know that pineapples take 2 whole years to grow?
No, I didn't, but did you know that a giraffe's tongue is about 2 feet? That's insane!
No, I didn't, but did you know that apples float because they're 1/4% of air?
No, I didn't, but did you know a python snake can eat a whole pig in one big gulp?
No, I didn't, but did you know it's time to go back to the studio?
No, I didn't, but now I do.
Now back to the studio with Palmer and Anya.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. I'm Evie from Ms. Leatherman's class, and I'm here with Ms. Cup. Who do we have here?
Here we have Jasper.
What type of cat is he?
Jasper is actually, we're not quite sure what he is. We just say he's an orange cat. Mm-hmm. But if I had to say, I would say he's a mix of a tabby cat and a rag doll, which is just a special kind of fluffy cat.
Can Jasper do any tricks?
He really can't do any tricks, but he does like to stand up and he can jump really high.
Is there any funny stories you can tell the school?
You know what? A funny story about Jasper would probably be one time, we could not find him for a little bit and we were wondering, he's trying to check everything out. Big stretch. Ah. Oh. So one time it was around Christmas last year and we actually really couldn't find Jasper. We were looking and looking and looking and we were like, where could he be? And we had just put up our Christmas tree and we had a white Christmas tree and he had actually climbed up in the middle of the Christmas tree and he blended right in. It took a little bit to find him, but when we finally did, we got him out, everything was good, but he was definitely trying to camouflage himself there for a little while.
Thank you, Miss Cup, and now it's time to go back to the studio with Ananya and Palmer.
Who let the dogs out?
Party was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a boom and shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the dance people had a ball, cause Billy Pong has get out. Get back, Gruffy, bash, Gruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I'm a no get angry.
Hey, yeah, V-I-O.
Two Eddie cows calling them canine. Hey,
V-I-O.
But they tell me, hey man, start up the party.
V-I-O.
You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Say, a doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold it.
A doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold it.
Hello. I'm Evan, and welcome to this week's current events. Roosters are two steps ahead of where we think they are. Believe it or not, roosters can recognize themselves in a mirror. In the past, scientists used an inaccurate form of testing, but now we can know the truth. Roosters squawk if they see a hawk or another predator to warn other roosters and chickens, but don't if they're alone. Scientists ran a test where they put a rooster in a room with a mirror and made a hawk shadow above the rooster, and even though it saw another chicken in the mirror, it recognized itself and did not squawk. So now you know the truth about roosters. On Monday, November 13th, people across Kenya took part in the country's first national tree planting holiday. The holiday was created by Kenya's president, William Ruto, to encourage people to plant trees as part of a plan to fight the climate crisis. Scientists have revived two small worms that have been frozen for 46,000 years. They are microscopic, so you can only see them with a microscope. They are also a brand new species. Now, thanks for tuning in. Now back to Ananya and Palmer in the studio. Goodbye.
Next up is Shane with Word of the Week.
Let's see what this week's word is.
Hi, I'm Shane from Miss Nuttall's class, and I'm here for Word of the Week. This week's Word of the Week is perspective. It means a point of view. A sentence to describe perspective is the book is based on the main character's perspective. So let's play a game. I'm going to tell you a sentence, and you're going to figure out if the word perspective is used right in the sentence. If it's right, stand up. If it's wrong, sit down. Ryan was seen a lot in the movie, so it must be about his perspective. You should be standing up. Justin was showing perspective by doing all of his work in class. You should be sitting down. Lastly, the teacher was talking to the class, so the students knew it was her perspective. You should be standing up. That's all for Word of the Week. Now back to Palmer and an Onion Studio.
I never knew words could mean this much.
Now let's go to Person of the Week with Maddie. Take it away, Maddie.
Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is Maddie from Mrs. Van Dam's class, and welcome to this week's edition of Person of the Week. This week's person is John Harrington. You might be wondering, who is John Harrington? John Harrington became the first Native American in space. Can you believe that? On November 23rd, 2002 was when he took off to space for NASA. He grew up in Colorado, Wyoming, and Texas. He attended college at the University of Colorado in Colorado Springs, where he received a bachelor's degree in applied mathematics in 1983. In 2014, after he retired from his flying career, he earned a doctorate in education from the University of Idaho. That's all for this week's Person of the Week. Now back to Ananya and Palmer in the studio.
Wow, that's very interesting.
Yeah, I know so much about John Harrington.
Next up, we have Lila with leadership. Lila, take it away, Lila.
Hi, I'm Lila from Ms. Nell's class. This week's leadership skill is regulation. Regulation means to have self-control. An example of regulation is if you're very, very angry because someone said something mean, you don't say something mean back. I'm going to ask you questions, and you give me a thumbs up for if it shows regulation, or a thumbs down if not. Richard said something mean to Sam, so I punched him. Thumbs down. Peggy said Eliza's dress was ugly, but Eliza did not say something mean back. Thumbs up. Now back to the studio with Palmer and Ananya.
Wow, nice job with leadership, Lila.
Now let's go to June with teacher feature. Take it away, June.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. I'm June from Ms. Nettle's class, and this week we have Ms. Nettle.
Hi!
Ms. Nettle.
I'm so glad to be here, June.
Ms. Nettle, what is your go-to Starbucks drink?
Ooh, I actually really like tea, and if I don't get a tea, then I like the brown sugar shaken espresso.
Sounds really delicious. What's your favorite holiday?
Thanksgiving, actually, and we just had Thanksgiving. I love getting to see my family and eating lots of good food.
I love that holiday. Who's your favorite singer?
My favorite singer is Sarah Bareilles, but my second favorite singer is Taylor Swift.
I love her. And do you have any pets?
I do. I have a kitty cat. Her name is Serafina, and she is black and orange, and she's the best kitty in the whole world.
Oh, I bet she's so cute. Well, thank you, Ms. Nettle.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for tuning in. Now back to the studio.
Thank you, June and Ms. Nettle.
Lastly, we have Luke with SD Puzzle.
Hi, I'm Luke from Ms. Davis's class, and I'm here with this week's SD puzzle. In the SD puzzle, you will have to guess how many objects are in the cup. I'll give you clues, and you can change your guess after each one. After I say the final clue, you will make your final guess, and then I will reveal the answer. How many spiky balls are in the cup? Clue one, the answer is a two-digit number. Clue two, the answer is an odd number. Clue three, the answer is a multiple of three. Clue four, the answer does not include the digit one, the digit three, and the digit five. Clue five, the answer is between 70 and 100. Make your final guess. The answer is 99. Did you get it? Now back to June and Evie in the studio.
Did you get it right?
I'm Ananya.
And I'm Palmer. We
will end with National Anthem,
Leadership Pledge, and a moment of silence. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the prairie.
I pledge, as a Prairie Trace Elementary leader, to have a positive attitude each day. I will make good choices even when no one is looking. I will demonstrate the leadership skills to make myself and my school an amazing place.